News 8 WMTW-TV. From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 NOW update.
Thanks for joining us for News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss. Just hours to go before their big debate tonight. Republican presidential candidates were out and about in New Hampshire today. Front runner Mitt Romney returned to the Granite State. Former Massachusetts governor had spent the last few days actually campaigning in South Carolina. Romney addressed supporters at a rally in Derry this afternoon. Slumping Newt Gingrich was trying to sway voters in Wolfboro. Former speaker has been steadily declining in the polls since December. But the Iowa runner-up, Rick Santorum, he's seeing a nice boost in the polls in New Hampshire. He hosted a town hall meeting in Hollis. John Huntsman also had a town hall in Haverhill. Candidates use these last events before the debate as a way to hammer home their platforms.
I look at the executive branch, ladies and gentlemen. No trust. At a time when this nation needs leadership like never before, we are not being led. At a time when we need fixes on debt and spending and tax reform, this bipartisan commission, Simpson-Bowles, drops right on the president's desk. A perfect way to go forward. It goes right in the garbage can. I said, what is this all about? No trust, no leadership.
Huntsman skipped the Iowa caucus to focus on New Hampshire. First, the nation primary takes place in just a few days. Tonight, candidates will square off in that debate. Two teenagers are dead, another in the hospital after a car crash in Western Maine. Police say 19-year-old Logan Dam and 16-year-old Rebecca Mason, both of West Paris, were killed instantly when the car they were riding in went airborne and crashed into a group of trees off Route 219 just after midnight. The driver, 18-year-old Christina Lowe of Paris, is currently at Maine Medical Center in critical condition. We're told there was another passenger in the car and that he has non-life-threatening injuries. Police believe the driver had been drinking and was texting at the time of the crash. Governor Paula Page is urging residents not to sign a referendum petition that focuses on renewable energy sources. In his weekly radio address today, LePage says the Maine Citizens for Clean Energy Coalition is collecting signatures for a November ballot initiative that would increase energy costs while padding the pockets of special interests. Question will ask voters if they want to require that at least 20% of Maine's electricity come from new renewable energy sources by 2020. LePage says Mainers should have choices but shouldn't be forced to buy certain types of alternative energy, especially if it's more expensive. LePage says right now Mainers pay 42% above the national average for electricity. Ayla Reynolds' father is now offering an explanation of why his 21-month-old daughter has a broken arm. Justin DiPietro says that the accident happened when he tripped and fell while carrying Ayla and landed on top of her. DiPietro told the Morning Sentinel that he was carrying a bag of groceries and with Ayla and tripped and fell on a set of stairs leading to the kitchen and that he landed on top of her. He says that he took Ayla to the hospital the next day when her arm began to swell. DiPietro reported Ayla missing from his mother's home in Waterville where he and his daughter were living on December 17th. Thank you for joining us here for News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us for your latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.